here tonight. Everybody. Does anyone here know who we are? No, that guy, I just presume, is it?
No, we have a
picture show,
right?
I'm
Phil.
I've got the one I'm wearing, I've literally one job. Hi, my name is Dan.
And my name is Phil.
Oh, good, it seems some of you recognize us. Wait, hello, there we are. Okay, well, no, it doesn't know who we are. I think that we're intimate enough as a group of people that you can just call me Dan. It's okay, I won't get offended. I feel like Whipple as close as you. What can you shorten your suit?
Well, I mean, I've got a thing about stages. I tend to mess up on a stage. I've had one time where I had my fly-ins in the whole time.
You're in the danger zone, people down there, seriously.
I did fall off the stage, so I've been told I can't go towards any of the edges.
It's actually the shadow splash zone. We were brought here today to be kind of like the wholesome community come together in the last of the night. Because you're like, damn it, Phil.
Fun, good times, and let me say that that was quite a bit. I'd say it's gonna be more of a horror story. Yeah. So, some of you may have noticed that we tweeted that we were coming here about 2 days ago.
Yeah.
Did you notice that? So, how is it that no one saw us when we just arrived? We have something kind of terrible to admit. Something terrible happened. Are you saying my microphone? Is it bad? That's why I sound like a yawn.
Hello, everybody.
I have an underwater microphone here. Well, we have something harrowing to admit.
Yeah.
It might not be the fun, peaceful ending tonight that we were all expecting, but I think something that we know from our careers is that sharing our pain makes other people happy. So do you want to share on this?
Story time with Dan and Phil.
We are never gonna. Oh, hello, bloody hell. A bit of my inner wrong reasoning came out there. This is something that we'll never tell again, so this is an experience just between us and you this evening. We have had the worst 2 days of our entire life, literally just now.
It all started with a dream.
like any good Hollywood movie,
I know.
A sequence that makes no sense.
So I had a dream that Dan lost his passport.
Which I never do because I am incredibly organized.
Yeah.
That's not a very interesting dream.
I mean, Benedict Cumberbatch was there riding on the back of a unicorn.
Just like a safe for work version of whatever was going on in your head that we probably don't remember.
But that's how it started. Anyway, we woke up the morning of our flight. Everything was fine. We had a breezy morning.
You know, that's the last thing you ever have a breezy morning when you go to an airport. You're screaming, everything's on fire, you're panicking, your family's breaking down. But on this day,
everything was going right.
So smooth, you have no idea. We were just like lazing about, just like watching 3 episodes of an anime in the morning, just because we could.
Crossing our plans in the taxi arrived. We were ready, took the cases down to the taxi.
It was like, we had so much time that I changed my outfit 3 times. It's that thing where we were like, I could go outside looking like this, but I have 10 minutes. That's how confident we were.
So we were about to walk out the door when Dan went really pale. Like, the pale time, like his whole internet history had been leaked.
That would be nowhere near, like,
You're like
it was bad.
It was bad.
It turns out that I had lost my passport. At the exact moment. So it turns out, like, I was so confident that I was prepared and everything was fine that I just hadn't thought about my passport.
Is that the first thing you think of?
Well, I did on that day. Like, everything was fine. And then we were there, and then suddenly it was like time to go, and I was like, oh. The one thing I'm supposed to remember, I don't know where it is, awkward. So
this was all Dan's fault.
Wait. There's more to this story. Okay. But yeah, we went to look for it.
We had to ransack the house. We were
destroying everything.
I had to look inside Dan's bedside drawer. I'm not going to say what it's wrong.
Whatever you're thinking, it's probably not as bad as what I saw. That was then. I have no idea why. Places in your house that are like the surfaces where stuff goes, and it doesn't make sense, but they're just like the stuff places where if you've lost something, you're like, it's gonna be on one of these, you know, the stuff pile.
It wasn't on the stuff pile.
What do you do when it's not on the pile that the stuff would be on?
Meanwhile, the taxi man is honking outside, he's blocking the traffic. I'm like, Dan, what are we gonna do?
He was threatening to just leave without us, and we were doomed, and then suddenly. In that like sudden moment, I realized, oh wait, I changed my outfit 3 times. My passport was in a pair of jeans that was now in my suitcase in the car.
Dan!
We run downstairs and I get my suitcase out and I start looking for it.
He was emptying his suitcase into the street. His boxer shorts.
They were clean, lovely underwear, a wonderful for any of the passers-by to notice.
It was holding up the traffic.
It was horrendously embarrassing, but no worries, we found it. Christ,
we found our passport.
Surely, plenty of time, we got in the car. Now this day, I'm sure you saw lots of British people being like, oh, it's really warm at the moment.
So
have you seen that? Like, okay, I know if you're from Phoenix, it's what today is in England. But honestly, look at how pale Phil is, okay? Us British people, we are so sensitive to the heat. So on this day, he didn't have the aircon in the car. It was like one of those situations that might kill a dog.
Yeah,
you know what I'm talking about?
I felt like I was in a lizard tank. I couldn't breathe, the windows wouldn't open. And then we had the taxi driver who was slightly strange. He didn't know where he was going.
It was
like the first
insane
time he'd driven in London and everything was stopped. We couldn't get anywhere.
We drove past some protesters. He wound down the window and shouted, "Get a job!"
Yeah!
And obviously, me and Phil being so awkward, we were just like,
"Stop it!"
Screaming!
He was swearing at his sat-nav and calling it.
He was actually
love.
Yeah.
I mean, like, no love. We can't go this way.
He said some bad things, like I can't repeat.
What does he do to that sat-nav when we're not here?
So it was a genuinely traumatizing, situation. But it's okay, because when you book a car to take you to an airport, you allow plenty of time for the journey, don't you? So I was looking and I was like, you've got ages. Suddenly panicked. It had seemed, for some reason, we had left an hour later than we were supposed to on the car. Now, why was that? Why was the car booked an hour later than supposed to be? This is a good one, okay?
I booked it in the wrong time zone.
British summertime, which is plus one. I literally booked a car in the wrong time zone.
Anyway.
So after the passport freak out, I was like, don't worry, we're fine. We're not fine.
We're not going to make
it. We're so incredibly not fine right now.
So we were slowly getting to the airport. We were on the clock. We had 10 minutes to get there. It was 10 minutes before everything was going to be over. We were going to miss the flight. We were going to miss Vidcon. Then we pulled up. We pulled up to the airport. We ran. I've
it's
never
one
ran
of those things where you literally have 2 minutes between this life or death situation. So it comes down to, are you going to run right now? Because how much you exercise is what's going to decide how this situation works. Now, to me, it feels like nothing in our life has trained us for this moment. Here we go!
I've never done so much exercise before.
That's how we run.
I was coughing up blood. I was crawling towards the desk.
I don't remember last time I went to an airport after the bloody Bahamas in July. The last time I tried to come into America, I got deported to the Bahamas. Good times. So again, I was like, I find myself like crying blood in an airport because I've been running so much.
Yeah.
And we see the air hostess at the end of the corridor, and she's just like standing and smiling. Surely good news. Why would anybody be grinning?
And then with the grin still on her face, she said, "I'm sorry, you've missed your flight, loves."
How late are you? And she was like, "Oh, we closed bag drop 2 minutes ago." I'm sorry. And we were like, "What?
2 minutes?"
And she said, "There's nothing I can do. You've missed the flight." So we were like, "What?" Ah. We went into like full on freak out mode because this
I just sat on the floor. I'm sitting on the floor until you take me on the plane.
I freaked out. Phil just gave up hope completely.
Yeah,
that is still freak out mode. But it was serious because flight was supposed to take us here for last night.
Yeah.
And we thought surely all the flights to Vidcon will be full. We've missed Vidcon.
Yeah.
And there is literally no way people are going to turn up to our meetup and just be like, "Well, that was fun. Met Dan and Phil." So literally, we were on the verge of tears. We were throwing up.
Yeah.
Everything was terrible.
Until we found out it was a very early morning flight and there was 2 seats left on.
When if you have a choice, you're like, why would I put myself through that hell? There's no reason. Who would get on the plane at that time? But me and Phil were like,
yeah,
it's this or that. Are we going to do it? We decided to get on the flight in the middle of the night.
Yeah.
So, literally, okay, without sleeping from the day before, which was like an early start to the day.
I think I've been awake for about 47 hours.
I don't even know. We got on the plane. This plane landed 2 hours ago.
Oh my god.
Literally, we ran through the airport, got in the car, like LA traffic, here we are for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Got in time to sleep.
That is still wearing the outfit you had on the plane.
Wondering why it has like a little stain there. I spilled some food on myself. Okay, I slept in that. I've been wearing this sweater for like 2 days now. I'm sorry. You can smell it on here, can't you? I'm sorry.
Yeah. So sorry, we look slightly like rats, but we made it to Vidcon.
I don't know what you're thinking from this impression of us right now, but Phil, how do you feel physically in this moment?
I feel like it was all your fault.
Okay, I was hoping that this would get us some like sympathy from the audience, but I see. Okay, no. You think it's my fault?
I think it's all your fault.
No. I lost my passport. We left it for 20 minutes. You got the car wrong by an hour.
I think we need to ask these guys. Alright?
I wonder how this is gonna go. Sure, okay, let's play the audience blame game.
Who thinks it was my fault?
I'm just gonna say mathematically is correct, but yeah, sure.
And who thinks it was Dan's fault?
That I didn't sleep for 3 days to come see you. Can we just agree that really it was all the cab driver's fault?
No, it was Dan's fault.
So, I mean, what can we learn from this? This was such a horrendous experience. There must be some kind of moral to the story.
I think the moral to the story is always believe in Phil's dreams.
No. Make sure the guy driving you knows at the airport is a credit. Or even like make sure your phone's not set to like Germany time or something.
No. You're just waiting for Benedict Cumberbatch to trot past the
airport. If you know the truth, you should all be terrified. Yeah. Trust me, that's not a lot of women. Yeah, I mean, was it worth it? Did we come all this way just to- Phil, they're gonna so like wholesome and fun, and we're like, death, pain, and suffering!
About everything happening with your days.
I think we've all learned something important here. We all feel better. We're just really glad that we got to come here and see all of you. It's definitely
an amazing Vidcon.
Yeah, I hope you had a fun weekend. Come to our community, see some pictures, have some bats.